I'm AJ, and thanks for taking the time out of your day to watch this video. If you're not a current subscriber, make sure you hit that subscribe button down below. Hit the like button because you're going to like this video, and also hit the notification bell so you'll be notified the next time I create a video. Today, we're going to talk about a few more bank accounts that can get you a really high interest rate. And technically, these are not savings accounts. Some of them aren't even checking accounts. But these are banks that you may not have ever heard of, and they're not your traditional banks, the big banks like Bank of America, Wells Fargo, SunTrust, banks like that. Similar to the online savings accounts that I've mentioned in previous videos, and make sure you check those out as well. These checking accounts, they're getting at least a 2% interest rate, and some of them are checking accounts, some are savings combined, and they may call those cash management accounts. But I really wanted to highlight these specific accounts, and this is sort of a top five. They're not really ranked because these are not banks, except for one that I've actually used myself. But in doing research for high interest accounts, these are some that popped up on my radar and that give you the option to use it just like a checking account, unlike some of those online savings accounts where you have certain limits to the amount of withdrawals that you can have. The first account I found was an account called Aspiration. With Aspiration's spend and save account, you get a 2% interest rate. And there are no minimum balances, no ATM fees, no monthly fees, and no overdraft fees. So it's absolutely no fees for this account. And you even have the option to get cashback rewards when you use your debit card to make purchases. Now, before this year, this isn't a bank that I had ever heard of, and I haven't seen too many reviews out there or too many people that I know of that have even heard of it. So I wanted to highlight this account, although it's not something that I have used personally. Now, another account I would like to highlight is called Simple. And this I've actually seen in the past. It's not something that I've actually used, but I have actually heard about it. And with Simple Mobile, and not the Simple Mobile like the cell phone company, but with the Simple Mobile checking account, you get a 2.02% interest rate. And similar to Aspiration, there's no minimum balance, there are no fees, and there are no ATM fees as long as you use the BBVA bank's network. So if you were to overdraft, those are automatically declined, so you don't have to worry about going over your account. As soon as you scan your card, if you don't have enough money, it will decline it, so you won't be worried about those fees that those big banks like Wells Fargo and Bank of America may charge you $35, or maybe they charge you a little bit less, like $10 or $20, just to transfer money from your savings account to your checking account to cover a purchase. One of the great things about Simple is they have a few budgeting and goal setting options. So similar to apps like Mint and Personal Capital, where you can track your finances, you can save money towards specific bills or specific goals, like maybe saving for a car or maybe for a down payment. They have this built into their checking account where you can actually show what your expenses are. So, you know, if you have a light bill, it's typically $70 to $80. You can put that in as an expense within their app. You can put your mortgage or your rent as an expense. And so as your money comes in from your paychecks, it will automatically be virtually separated into separate funds to cover your rent or your light bill or your phone bill, any expenses that you have. And it will split that up between your multiple paychecks if you need to, depending on your income and how much your expenses are. And that way you get a visual representation of where your money is going as far as specific expenses, and then that money is saved. And after all of those things are taken care of, it'll show a separate section of the money that you have left over that you can spend on whatever you choose. So that's something that's just really cool about the Simple Mobile account. Now the next bank, which is actually a checking slash savings hybrid, they call these cash management accounts, is SoFi Bank. Now I've spoken about SoFi Bank in the past, and I've actually done a review on this account. And this is an account that I've actually used. And with SoFi Bank, you get a 2.25% interest rate. And that's pretty good, especially because you can use it like a checking account. There are no limits to the amount of withdrawals that you can have throughout a month. Unlike with the traditional savings accounts and online savings accounts, there's a federal mandate to where you can't have more than six transactions per month without there being some sort of penalty. And for that account, there are no maximum balances. So for the 2.25% interest, you can put in as much money as you want into that account. And there are no limits or there are no changes to the amount of interest that you get once you get to a certain dollar amount. Another great thing about SoFi, and you can also check out my individual review of the SoFi Money app is that you also have the SoFi Invest app and you have their loan options all within a single app. So it's great if you already have SoFi loans, or if you plan on getting a mortgage or refinancing your student loans or getting a student loan, all of these accounts will be within that same application. And another great thing about SoFi Money is that when you make your initial deposit, if it's at least $100, you will actually get a $50 bonus just for opening an account and putting in $100. They're gonna give you $50. So that's a 50% return just for putting $100 in your account. So make sure you check out the links that I have in my description. You can use my referral link and you will get that $50 bonus. Now the next account is actually an account that you can use to invest as well. And it's called Wealthfront. Wealthfront has some automated investing options. Some people call them a robo-advisor, where you can put money in each month and they will automatically invest the funds based on your risk tolerance. So if this account, similar to SoFi Money, it is also a cash management account. So it's a hybrid checking and savings account. So you get the high rate of some of these online savings accounts, while also having the ability to use it as a checking account without the restrictions on the amount of transactions that you can have each month. And the interest rate for this account is 2.57%. Now, the thing that stood out about Wealthfront specifically is that when others were lowering their interest rates, most recently because they're expecting the Federal Reserve to lower interest rates, Wealthfront actually increased their interest rate. So I see this as sort of a power move for Wealthfront. When they see that others are lowering their interest rate, they increase theirs to make it more attractive for people who might have been thinking about Wealthfront or maybe probably haven't heard of Wealthfront. And like the other accounts mentioned, there are no fees. There's only a minimum of a dollar deposit to create an account. But at this time, unlike the other three that I mentioned, they do not have a debit card. That's something that they are planning on working on. But at the moment, you can only use it online. There is no debit card that you can use to go to an ATM or make purchases. So for right now, it's great for online purchases, or if you just want to have an account to put your savings in, your emergency fund, or maybe if you're saving for a mortgage. And last but not least, I actually thought this was a joke once I saw the name of this bank, but it's no joke that they have a 3% interest rate for their checking account. And that bank is called Redneck Bank. Yes, I said Redneck Bank. That's the name of their bank. And actually, if you go to their website, they have something that's kind of cool, a little bit creepy, but when you're scrolling on their website, there's like a fly that's jumping around on the page. And so as you scroll, that fly continues to move around. So that's something really quirky about the website. But out of the accounts that I just mentioned, they actually have the highest interest rate at 3%. Now, unlike the other banks that I mentioned, there are a few limitations and also a few hoops that you have to jump through in order to get that 3%. So in order to get the 3%, you have to have a minimum of 10 POS point of sale transactions per month. So that means you have to actually go out and use your debit card. If you're a person that uses your credit card to get cashback rewards or bonus points for using your credit card versus using your debit card, then this may not be a card for you because you're going to have to use it for at least 10 transactions. Now, what I've seen that some people have done in the past as a way to get around this or to actually, you know, get those 10 to make sure that they actually get 10 POS transactions is to maybe go out and buy a gift card at, you know, a Target or a Walmart or a store like that and just get those gift cards and then they can use those to make purchases elsewhere at any future time. There's also a minimum $500 deposit in order to create an account. Now, there is no minimum to maintain the account, but to initially open it, you do have to have a $500 deposit. Also, you don't get the 3% on an unlimited dollar amount. Once you go over $10,000, you don't get a 3% interest rate anymore. For everything that's over $10,000, you only get a 0.5% interest rate. So if you're a person that's gonna keep more than $10,000 in the account, then maybe one of the other accounts that I mentioned would be a better option for you. Now, on a slightly lower interest rate, Redneck Bank also have a savings account that they call a Mega Money Market account. And with this account, you can get 2.4% interest on up to $50,000. But like I said, if you happen to be a person that keeps more than $50,000 in your savings account, one of the other banks will be better for you because then you don't have that reduction of a rate. And Wealthfront is above that 2.4%. SoFi Money is pretty close with 2.25%. So depending on the features that you liked, out of all of the banks that I mentioned, you may want to choose one of those if you have a large sum of money that you're trying to keep in your savings account. Now, going back to that minimum number of transactions of 10 per month, and these are 10 POS transactions, if you don't meet that minimum, the interest rate for your account is only 0.25%. So that's something, if you do use their services, that is something you want to make sure that you're hitting that 10 POS transactions every month so that you can ensure that you're going to get that 3% interest rate on your balance below $10,000. So these are five of some of the little known banks that you can use to get a high interest rate on your checking and savings accounts. And that was Aspiration, Simple Mobile, SoFi Money, Wealthfront, and Redneck Bank. Make sure you check all of those out. I do have an individual review of SoFi Money, so make sure you check that out if you want to get a couple more details that I didn't mention in this video. And also make sure you use the link in the description. That'll give you a referral bonus of $50 once you create an account with a minimum of $100 deposit with SoFi Money. I do plan on doing an individual review of some of these accounts, definitely Wealthfront in the future. So make sure you stay tuned, and I will post links to that in this video once I actually do create it. So if these are bank accounts that you've used, make sure you leave a comment in the description. Let me know what you think about those specific banks. Do you like it? Do you not like it? Are there pros and cons that I haven't mentioned that you've experienced from actually using the account? We'd really like to hear what you have to say about those accounts. And once again, I really like to thank you for taking this time out of your day. You could have been doing anything with your time, so I really appreciate you watching. If you're not a current subscriber, make sure you hit that subscribe button down below. Hit the like button because you really like this video, and also hit the notification bell so you'll be notified the next time I create a video. All right, thanks for watching, guys. Have a great day.